Krishnot kirtano gano nartano kala patho jani vrajita sadbhakta valihamsa chakra madupo seni viharaspadam karananandi kaladhanir bahutume jivha maru prangani si jaitanya dhyani dheta balasad lila sudha sadhuni Krishnat kirtana gana nartana kala patho jani bhajita sadbhakta valihamsa chakra madupo seni viharaspadam karananandi kaladhanir bahutume jivha maru prangani si chaitanya dayani dheta balasad lila sudha swardhuni Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, I am going to submit unto the lotus feet of such a Sadguru who can give me 100% eternal benefit. Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, I am going to submit unto the lotus feet of such a Sadguru who can give me 100% eternal benefit. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that in Chaitanya Charitamrita there is one word, kai mano bakhye kare udveg na deve. In Chaitanya Charitamrita you can find one sloka there inside. Here Krishna Das Babaji Goswami writing that kai mano bakhye kare udveg na deve. By body, speech and mind, you should not give any tension to anybody. Be careful about that. Guru Padma used to speak, Baba, before leaving your body, if there is anybody who is you are thinking that you are his enemy, you are giving pain to somebody, then you cannot get siddhi. If you are going to give pain to anybody without any reason, then before leaving your body, maybe you are trying your bhajan, but you cannot come out successful. Siddhi you cannot get. So actually, this is one vital point, that we should not give pain to anybody. This is the motto of Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava. They never like to put anybody in trouble. From heart, they are praying to Supreme Lord, O Prabhu, you please arrange so that they can get some way out. Also, many times I used to speak the prayer of Prahlad Maharaj in front of Nishingadevi, can remember. Prayena deva munayo sabhi mukti kama maunam charanti vijanena pararthu nishtha naitana vihayo kipamano pimokshayeko nanyam tadasya saranam brahmatonu bhashe. Hey Prabhu, you will have to do something for them. They are Asura boys there. Without them, if you are not going to give kripa to them, then what I can do with kripa? You will have to arrange something for them so that they can reach their highest goal. Highest goal means highest good. This is the target of Guru Vaishnava, because our topmost thing, what is our target? That is called Krishna Prema. I can discuss by your blessing, by all your blessing, I can try to discuss very deeply about what is our target, how we can get Krishna Prema. And we have to compare this Prema, what you call love, what is in Urdu language, you can isk, you can speak isk in Urdu language. In English you can say love, but we say prema is not same. I can try to show all analytically by your all your blessing. But the vital point is that you can remember before leaving body, before leaving this material world, Prabhupada was bound to speak very, very clearly that I was bound to give them, I was bound to put them in trouble because I was bound to give them advice about actual Hari Bhajan. In the name of Hari Bhajan, if somebody doing something which is not at all Krishna Bhajan, I cannot tolerate. You all promise me that you are going to do Hari Bhajan, now you are going to cheat me. What is that? You all promise me that you are going to do Hari Bhajan, but now you are going to cheat me. I cannot tolerate. So in the name, I was bound to put everybody in trouble because I wanted to engage them in actual Hari Bhajan. So maybe they think me, I am their enemy. Be sure 100% I am in Vyasasan speaking. A Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, cannot have any enmity with anybody. Even those who want to kill him, beat him, insult him, still a Vaishnava can never want to take revenge against them. That is the first symptom of a Vaishnava. I can give one or two examples so that you can clearly understand. One Babaji Maharaj, very nice Babaji Maharaj from Navadvip Dham, used to go to Krishnanagar court and file case every day in police station and go to court to fight with some so-called sadhus, those who are doing all rubbish in the name of Hari Bhajan. They think to do Harinam in a solitary castle is Hari Bhajan. Actually, most of the people, they don't know what is Hari Bhajan. What do you mean by Hari Bhajan? Hari Bhajan means to satisfy Supreme Lord from your heart. You will have to try to satisfy it. Wholeheartedly, you will have to try to satisfy Supreme Lord, and at all your activities and your, you know, devotional activities going to satisfy Supreme Lord, that you will have to check up. You can say, I'm doing so much bhajan, but at all Supreme Lord not satisfied with you, Gurudev not satisfied, Guru Varga not satisfied, then how you can get success? That is the main problem. So, Prabhupada used to speak that some people speaking about public happiness, some of them speaking about private happiness, some of them speaking about public happiness, some of them speaking about private happiness, but we are not going to seek private happiness, neither private happiness nor public happiness. We are all the time, every fraction of second, going to find a way out to satisfy, to find the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. That is our target. That is our sole target. So actually, that Babaji Maharaj going every day, almost every day, and some group of so-called devotees, they think we are elevated devotees. They are going to Srila Satchidananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur. You see Thakur, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, every day he is going to court and here and police station to file case. He don't know bhajan, how to do bhajan, he don't know. Every day is his duty. What is this? He should mind his own business, own bhajan. Bhakti Vinod Thakur laughing, speaking. Yes, he is doing bhajan. Huh? He is doing bhajan? Yes, he is doing bhajan. He cannot tolerate that you are doing all rubbish in the name of Hari Bhajan. Somebody going to get, you know, secret woman association. Somebody going to take out money from Supreme Lord, as deposit of Supreme Lord here in temple, here. They are all rubbish activities they are doing. So, he cannot tolerate. That's why almost every day he is coming to file one case. He is doing Hari Bhajan. Your Harinam in a solitary castle is not at all bhajan. So be careful about that. So what is Hari Bhajan? What is not Hari Bhajan? Who is great Vaishnav? Who is not at all Vaishnav? Many times I told that quality and quantity cannot persist together. You cannot expect, not at all possible. Quality and quantity cannot exist together, persist together. Ravi Rajani nahi mile ek tham. Sun is there, at the same time, night time coming, how possible? Sun is there mean no night. Maybe some cloud going to cover the sun. Light is low, but you cannot expect night time and some sun in the sky at the same time. You cannot expect. It's not possible. So this way, it is my request unto your latest feet to everybody. Don't try to think I am have some party color, nothing. I am standing on neutral platform, the mercy of Prabhupada and Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Guru Varga. So I have my duty to speak all about that absolute truth. If I am going to hide something, then surely I am going to do some jiva himsa. You know jiva himsa? I am surely going to commit some jiva himsa. You think Prabhupada speaking, only Prabhupada can speak, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Only Gauriyamat can speak this thing, this Siddhanta, never in the whole universe, never you can get. Only Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Prabhupada speaking, you think some physical assault done on somebody, you think it is called, actually you are doing some physical assault, giving pain directly, you think you are doing jiva himsa? No. It is not actually jiva himsa. It is also jiva himsa, but it's not genuine jiva himsa. Genuine jiva himsa, how we can realize? But genuine jiva himsa means if you are not going to guide that jiva properly, you know how that jivatma can get its highest benefit. But you, due to your own pratishtha and you know own vanity, or don't do that, this you are speaking. That's why you are going committing jiva himsa. The topmost jiva himsa is to mislead or jivatma. Physical assault it's a bodily physical assault you are doing. It is also himsa, but actually jiva himsa is very deep meaning. I know everything. I am going to misguide you. I am going to cover up the truth, absolute truth. I am not going to, because some people can attack me, some kill me, they are going to stop my Harikatha. So that's why I am going to hide speaking about absolute truth. But I am the grand disciple of Srila Prabhupada, at least I am trying to become. So I must say, like Prabhupada used to say, if the whole world going against me, if the whole world going against me, still I am not going to stop speaking about that absolute truth, standing under the lotus feet, umbrella, lotus feet of my Guru Padma. Under the umbrella, I am in the lotus feet of my Guru Padma. I can go on speaking about that absolute truth. What can happen, let happen. Another example I can give, then you can understand the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Gradually I can try by your blessings. Actually, you can remember that Bhakti Vinod Thakur used to speak Chaitanya Charitamrita, recite Chaitanya Charitamrita Harikatha on Chaitanya Charitamrita there in Purushottam Dham. And there actually near Haridas Thakur, Samadhi Mandir, you know, you've been there. We also, many times we've been there. There actually, Haridas Thakur used to do Harinam. Srila Thakur wanted to do a bhajan under his guidance there, just near adjacent place. And in the afternoon time, Bhakti Vinod Thakur used to speak Chaitanya Charitamrita, very nice, sweet way. And that time, Bimala Prasad was also there. That time actually, Bhakti Vinod Thakur someday speaking, Bimala Prasad Prabhu, you will have to speak Chaitanya Charitamrita here in Vyasasana because I will have to go to Calcutta for some Seva. you will have to do this seva. Okay, as you order me, okay, dhanyavad. Then Bhakti Vinod Thakur gone and Prabhupada started speaking about Chaitanya Chaitanya in a very analytical way. Such a way we cannot expect that kind of analytical intermediation from anybody. From anybody, you cannot expect. And after some time, when Bhakti Vinod Thakur coming back, Bhakti Vinod Thakur discovered the number of audience going down. What can be the reason? Maybe he is speaking some rubbish. Not rubbish, maybe speaking something. When after that, Bhakti Vinod Thakur speaking, you go on speaking Harikatha. Though I come, but today, one or two days, you can speak, but I can speak after. You go on. Then Bhakti Vinod Thakur started hearing what he is speaking. After hearing Bhakti Vinod Thakur speaking, I cannot expect this kind of explanation you are doing. So, oh my God, now I know. You are so merciful, but they cannot understand you are so merciful. So the number of audience going down. Okay, okay, no problem. After a few days, some so-called devotees, they are actually dangerous people. In the base of Paramahansa, Sannyasa, they took decision to attack Prabhupada in a big way. Why you are speaking this way? Huh? This way? They took decision to attack Prabhupada anyway. If they find him outside, you know, Bhajan Kuchir, they can attack. Bhakti Vinod Thakur took this away. Very sorry, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Oh, you are going to do something good. You are going to give something immense treasure to them, but they are so idiot, so foolish. They cannot understand your heart. So better you go. Go to Brajapattan, Gaurdham, and start Naam Sankirtan in Harinam. This is a mala given to him. He gone there and started doing Harinam Sankirtan, Kotinam Jagadhyaya. Prabhupada often used to speak one thing. That is the practical situation. I promise I don't like to earn name, fame, money, nothing. Nothing. If you stop my Harikatha, it's okay. I'm not going to think about anything. But believe me, I am going to represent Prabhupada, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Guru Varga. Though I am unfit, still I am trying my best to speak what all I heard from Guru Varga. I cannot pay them for infinity payout. Anyway, also you remember, in Shastra we can get, whenever you get birth, that time you will have to pay four different kind of debts, you know. That is called Rishirin, Pitririn, Devarin, and Bhutarin. Four different kinds of debt, you know, Rin. You will have to pay them. After taking birth, you are already indebted to them. You will have to pay them somehow. What is the procedure? How you can pay them? What is the procedure? The procedure is that, Rishirin, if you like to pay, because we are coming from this, you know, parampara. So, Rishirin, you will have to pay. How? You will have to discuss all about their, you know, advice what they are speaking, about those Suddha Sattik Vichar, those who are speaking, and other rishis, some they are, and are passing different kind of remark also, you will have to tally and understand gradually. So, in Niti Shastra also you can find Muninam Chavi Brahmaha. Those rishis, they are also making mistake, so what wrong if I am doing? This is not the mood of bhajan. This is not the mood of bhajan. Those rishis, they are also making mistake. We go through Mahabharata, they are here and they are making. So what wrong if I... Idiot people, they are fighting like this. They can never do bhajan. We learn from Guru Varga, my son, they are not making a mistake. They are making one drama of mistake so that we can get milestone. in the way of our bhajan. That rishi doing this, oh my God, big rishi, I must be careful. I must be careful so that I can, there is no such mistake in my life. This is called mood of bhajan. Fighting in mood is not at all mood of bhajan. It's not at all mood of bhajan. So you see, actually, Muninam Chavi Brahma mean they are acting like that so that in future we can get some solution. So that in future we are not going to commit any offense or anything, any mistake in the way of our bhajan. That should be learned. Now point is that how Rishirin can be paid if we are going to discuss something that wise of like Vishwamitra Muni giving Gayatri Mantra. Who giving? Gayatri Mantra who giving? That Vishwamitra Muni. So we will have to chant and think about this Gayatri Mantra. Gayatri Mantra, in how to do bhajan, I learned from Guru Padma Guru Varga. Gradually I can try to write and speak my feeling. That Gayatri Mantra is very vital. Not Kam Gayatri. Kam Gayatri is more vital. It's a very secret thing. But this Gayatri, Brahma Gayatri is very important. I can try to write and discuss. That this Gayatri Mantra can help you to cut material bondage. For infinity, infinity period, we have our bondage. No way out how to cut this bondage. No way out. Only Prabhupada speaking, those who are going to take shelter unto the lotus feet of a genuine Sadguru, and they are going to do perfect seva of that Sadguru to satisfy him. Through only this procedure, you can cut material bondage. A great scholar, he has a proficiency. He is going to advise you Gayatri Mantra Diksha. No way out. You cannot. The only way, I say you, be careful. And after getting mantra, you will have to do bhajan under the guidance of that Sadguru proper way. And Sadguru can never advise you wrongly. We are going to follow the unique spiritual master Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is going to act as a master, guru. Krishnam Bande Jagat Gurum. When Krishna is going to teach us, somebody says, oh, Yusda is speaking, worship me, worship me, worship me. Oh, everybody is speaking. Who is going to worship you? Krishna says, are I am speaking them right, I am showing them right way. They think I am, misguiding them. Oh my God. Then I will have to come, changing my clothes and everything, dress and cover. This is the procedure. Actually, Krishna is speaking rightly. Madhyaji mang namaskuru. You worship me, you think about me. I can deliver you. Ma sucho. Aham tvam makshai swami ma sucho. Don't repent. Sure, I am going to. You are going to repent. You are playing with gopikas, you are doing this, then you can. How you can do? We are expressing doubt. Okay. When I am speaking this way, they cannot understand me. So let me try again in different. So you see, when Supreme Lord coming, still they are going to misunderstand who am I. A small creature in this infinity universe. If I look at sky, I think, who am I? Insect? Not. In comparison to a whole infinity universe, who am I? What is my identity? Oh my God, who am I? In that case, some kind of humility can touch my heart. If I think I have done everything, who are you? Then, Supreme Lord going to give me punishment, heavy way. So you see, Rishir in this way you can pay, you will have to discuss about their treasure, what they wanted to give us. Rishir in this way, Rishir in as a pitrin, you will have to lead your family life very nicely. First of all, brahmacharya, first of all, brahmacharya, garhastha, and grahastha life, you will have to give birth to a, you know, boy who can do some ritualistic activity after your death, pinda. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also speaking him? They actually will have to give birth to a son who can arrange your funeral activities after it. Pinda, pindadan you have to do. If there is nobody to give water and, you know, cake, funeral cake, then this is very dangerous. So this is one kind of payment to Pitrin. Pitrilog, you can pay to them. And Devarin, how you can remember, minimum thing you are not going to discuss very deeply. You are not going to discuss how you can understand the secrecy of bhajan. That is the main thing. Actually, it is written that actually Krishna Bhagavan, Krishna speaking to Arjun. Actually, Brahma, after creating this material world, giving order to those demigods to serve, give the duties as ordered by Supreme Lord, I am doing, I also give them order. So it is called delegation of authority. In economics, in management, you can find one thing. This is called delegation of authority. Delegation of authority means from higher authority, and this order can pass on and on and on and come down to you. Flowing, delegation of authority, flowing of order. Command giving from high level, and command can come and touch me. I am also become active to do. That is called, that in economics we say, delegation of authority, flowing of power, we can say this way. So demigods, they are bound to give their service. Why not? They are holding one separate cabinet. Why not? Hey, do. And you, human being, also you have to do your duty. You can serve them also. How? You can do jagya, this, that, swaha, indaya swaha, varunaya swaha. You have to do. So you are going to give clarified butter to them. They are going, and Agni fire going to carry their prasadam to them. Indra, this is your share. This way, all demigods going to get their share. Indra is in Agni serving them. About Agni, there is very nice mantra in Veda. Someday, Om Agnim Ile. This very nicest mantra, someday I can discuss, but this is not the time because Gaur Purnima coming. So I'll have to touch the vital point. How Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to preach, how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to seek the benefit of this common people, public, you will have to think that way. You have to think that way. So you see, so Rishirin, Pitririn, Devrin, you will have to pay how? But they can give service to you. Also you will have to worship them, give them offer, their, you know, obalance, you will have to give. This way you will have to serve them. And Bhutarin, how? Bhutarin, you have to, in this material world, you have taken birth. Each and every fraction of seven, you have some duty for other jivas. If you think, well, I have no duty, no nothing, it's not good. You have duty. You will have to do something concrete for this society, this, that. This I'm speaking for common people. Those who are going to do Hari Bhajan, definite way, 100%. Not that those who are going to do something else in the name of Hari Bhajan. I'm not speaking about them. Those who are, their commitment is there. I must do or die. This is the motto of Hari Bhajan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaching us. But if you go through Chaitanya Bhagavata, nowhere you can find, Maharaj, where is reading you, speaking, it is a teaching of, yes, I can show you. Nowhere you can find, you can go to Chaitanya Bhagavata, Chaitanya, where is it? No I don't find such a word there. I can show you that all Goswami Granthas and all, you know, and, you know, this Kavi Karnapur giving the, you know, feeling of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. After taking sannyas, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to speak. After taking sannyas, what is the feeling of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you should remember. Then I can go back to the teachings of Prabhupada. Teachings of Prabhupada mean teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. 100% I am in Vyasasan, you can burn me off if I am speaking lie. The teachings of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Prabhupada, his teachings means exact teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If you go directly through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's day, you cannot understand. So analytically, he is explaining this way. So there you can find what is the feeling of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu after taking sannyas. What is the feeling of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu after taking sannyas? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking that I have taken sannyas. I am not going to think about my future. What future? I am going to do Hari Bhajan. I have taken sannyas in my life. So, who is man going to care about what is my future? If one sannyasi, one acharya is going to think about his own future, he is a fallen soul. Not at all acharya. He cannot misguide people that way. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking that I am already going to jump into the ocean of beauty, ocean of, you know, pastimes of Leela, Leela Rasamrita Sagar of Krishna. Krishna is the infinity ocean, Rasa Sagar, infinity ocean of Rasa. Who care, man? I have taken sannyas for why? To enjoy? I have taken sannyas to jump into that ocean. If I die or leave, what can happen today, tomorrow? Who care? It is the feeling of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking this way, that I have, Prabhu kahe, Mukunda sevan bato kaila grahan. Mukunda seva hai, sangsat taran. Mukunda seva hai, sangsat taran. If you are going to Muku, Guru Padma used to speak, some Guru Varga also, nice explanation by Vishnu. Muku mean prema. Mukur in Sanskrit, mirror also. But here, Muku, Do mean, is going to do. Prema Do. Do mane dan, you're going to give. So, Mukunda. Mukunda mean, who is going to give prema. It's called Mukunda. So, Prabhu kahe, Mukunda sevan rato kahila grahan. I have taken resolution in my life to serve Mukunda, Nanda Krishna, exclusive way. So, this way, I can help myself, I can help others people to cross this material world. I can also help others to cross this, because I am totally established in this Siddhanta Vichar. If I myself is not established in Siddhanta Vichar, how I can help you to cross material? Nothing. I cannot do. In Mahabharata, life is very short. Who can have this kind of power, of bhajan power, who can remember everything, all sastra words, and come gradually to tally. Like card playing, you see, card playing, this kind of matching. In Mahabharata, we can find one nice advice. Tirnam Tareta, who is already crossed, you already crossed this material ocean, he can help you for crossing. Who is already there in the midway, in the ocean himself, going to die. How he can help you? I don't know. You all foolish number one, so you are going to believe them? They are in midway, in the ocean, in the midway. Oh, water going, they are going to deep into what? How they can? So in Mahabharata, don't try to read Mahabharata. You can die. Don't try to read Mahabharata. Prabhupada used to speak, well, it is Jaya Grantha, but still you cannot extract the exact meaning. You can misunderstand. So many things are there, you can puzzle. Is he doing this? He is doing this? Oh my God! You cannot come out successful. That's why many times I speak that those Goswami going to stir the whole ocean of Shastra, Anantaparam Kila Sabda Shastram. Shabda Shastra is the ocean. From there they are going to stir and get the cream for you, me, for everybody. Don't try to take trouble. You can die, you can misunderstand. That's why in Srinivasa you are writing about Saragoswami, Nana Sasta Vichara Naiko Nipuno, Shaddharma Sangstapako, Lokanang Hitakarino Tibabane, Manyo Saran Nakaru. That's why it is written. Another point that most of us cannot understand, we don't have common sense. In Chaitanya Bhagavad, we find one word in Premibhartosa. Jejan Krishna Bhaje Sehaya Bara Chatur. He is very, very clever. Those who are going to Krishna Bhajan, they are so clever, so clever. But clever not like crow. But not clever like vulture. Follow. Not clever like eagle. They are clever like Paramahansa, to get the exact cream. Don't misunderstand me. So you see, in there we cannot understand what is the meaning. It is written, those who are going to get a dirty spiritual lover, spiritual leader, or maybe not about speaking about spiritual leader, about country or continent, can speak. You can see, there it is written that Nasanti Anayaka. At the time of Ben Maharaj, there was nobody to rule. There was nobody because Ben already going to die. Ben already died. There's rishis, they burned them up. Ben Maharaj died. After that, nobody there to get control over the situation. All dacoits and thieves or arrogant people, you know, those were, they are getting an opportunity to fight each other, cut. What to do? Ben gone. So it is written, Nasanti Anayaka. If there is no leader to guide you, then you are going to die. Whole society is going to die. Nasanti Anayaka. Nasanti Kunayaka. If somebody is sitting in the chair, highest level, he is going to give command, but he is notorious people. Kunayaka, ku mean, his attention is there in material thing, not in devotion. One foreign philosopher, you can go through my cow books, Klaus Otter, Chetanaka Jagran, there I already, I forget the name, he write, any leader of this society, any leader, any minister, any leader of this society, they must be 100% philosopher. I was very stunned. Really so? I like to pay dandavat to him. So nice he was speaking. Really so? I think deeply. What? He is thinking about very... Oh, nice. Really so? At present, those who are political, they are idiot, foolish. They have no darshan. They are actually mad, like mad dog. They are biting each other. Like mad dog. How they can guide? They cannot. They have no discipline, no controlling over their own life. How they can guide others? This is the situation. I was speaking in Chandrakana, in Bengali of course. Those street dogs, I was speaking in Bengali, those street dogs, they are speaking, ho human being, ho man, how you are man? You are fighting with each other all the time without any reason for Labha-puja-pratishtha. We are fighting only for bread. If any dog coming from one locality to our place, we are fighting, ga 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 ga. Why? Because barking, because we want to take bread in our locality. Why you come here? This is the only reason. But you are fighting with each other all the time. All the time. Without any reason, you are getting a golden opportunity to do Krishna bhajan. So those dogs with falling and speaking, oh man, how you are human? How we can say that you are a human being? We are fighting for some small reason. You are fighting all the time with each other. No reason. Biting each other. Prabhupada used to speak. You don't know. I heard it from the senior most devotee of our Guru Varga. You cannot believe it now. If I speak, it's revolting. You cannot understand how Prabhupada could see everything. That what they are going to do. Prabhupada is not so cheap. Prabhupada is not so cheap, Acharya. Prabhupada can see your past, present and future. Prabhupada speaking. There's Jadubangsa going to be destroyed. Jadubangsa going to be destroyed. They can fight with each other without any reason. Without any reason they are fighting with each other. What reason can be there? If your target is Krishna Prema, why you are fighting? What you can get out of that? Prabhupada speaking, forecast. 60, 70 years back, one day Prabhupada was supposed to take prasadam. And Paramananda Babu already served prasadam. Prabhupada in front of plate, sitting, not taking prasadam, and looking outside garden. After some time, Paramananda Babu entered. Prabhupada, you are not taking prasadam? You are not taking prasadam? Long time, what you are thinking? What you are looking there? I am looking that you are going to burn up your luck, good luck. You are going to burn. Your luck already burnt up and, you know, converted into ass. Tomader kopal pure chai hoye geche in Bengali. Tomader kopal pure che. That I am looking. I come here to give you treasure. But preliminary thing you cannot digest. Preliminary thing you cannot digest. So how? What to speak about Raganuga, Rupanuga, what to speak about leadership, what? Prabhupada was speaking this way, very heavy heart. So, Nashanti Anayaka, those who are having no controlling, no leadership, they are going to die. Nashanti Kunayaka, those who are going to get bad leadership, kill you. Spiritually, physically, everything, you are going to lose everything. Be sure about that. You will have to take precaution and measure. After that, Nashanti Anayaka, Nashanti Kunayaka, Nashanti Bahunayaka. Those who are having so many leaders in the society. Oh, he is also a leader. He is also a leader. He is also a leader. He is also... Oh my God. Minimum thing from Shastra you don't understand. That's why you take decision to make leader everywhere. Oh, you also can act as leader. Ready? Minimum thing you don't understand. Wow, A, B, C, D you don't understand. You understand? A, B, C, D? How we can know? Your activity is going to prove that you don't understand A, B, C, D of bhajan. I am not expressing any doubt about anyone. I am speaking the absolute truth. Whatever can be my consequent, I am not going to think. My life is totally dedicated for Prabhupada, Bani Seva. I am not going to speak any lie to anybody. So, Nasanti Anayaka, Nasanti Kunayaka, Nasanti Bahunayaka. There are many leaders in there. He is also fighting, bass. Then, what is the solution? Taranti Sunayaka. Who can cross this river? who is going to enjoy the leadership of a sunayak, very good, who is a very discrimination, very nice, he can think, he having devotion, like Pithu Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj. Devotion, devotion, devotion is power. Bhakti is Shakti. Bhakti is Shakti. Why Parikshit Maharaj can get control over whole world? Why Pithu Maharaj can get control over whole world? Whereas you cannot get control over your own family. Why? Lack of bhakti, devotion. So you see, Prabhupada used to speak very with heavy heart. I was to see that actually, if somebody going to make a very nice building, you yourself cannot make a building in your whole life, I know. But you can destroy, demolish that building. That you can do. Prabhupada with heavy heart. Griharambe anasakta. Biharam ke asaktam griharambe. Griharambe I cannot make. Saktam? Asaktam griharambe saktam. I forget that meaning to destroy. I can speak after some time, I can remember. You cannot make one building, but if someone going to build, you are going to destroy. That you can do very well. You can destroy the whole world, devotional world, with your personal opinion and Siddhanta. But you cannot help to give nourishment to the vichara bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. That is your efficiency, capacity. That is your efficiency, that you can do. Prabhupada used to speak with heavy heart. So we will have to think over it again, all the issue, you see. With heavy heart we'll have to think, very heavily we'll have to think about this point. So, giharambhe anasaktya saktam, forget, to destroy, this he can do. So now actually point is that, the condition of bonded soul is very, very painful. Very, very painful. Very, very painful. If you can realize, then you can cry day and night to get solution. If you cannot understand, realize this point, then you are not going to find any solution. Somebody is speaking, Maharaj. Actually, we heard one English word. Then prevention is better than cure. I can develop some disease. Okay, I have enough money. I can go to doctor and find. Why not you take precautionary measure so that you never you are going to get one disease? It's far better. So actually, from the extract of total Bhagavatam, total vital point teachings from Bhagavatam, we see. Ultimately, what are you going to do? That is different. But you will have to remember. Sutasya pungsam suchira samasya nanjosa surir viritartha tattat gunanu sabanam mukunda padarabinda hidesh jesham. You will have to give honor. You have to give full seva to those devotees, great exalted devotees, those who are going to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They are actually honeybees. You have to serve them. What benefit I can get? What not you can get? What benefit I can get? What not you can get? You can get everything. What not you can get? If you get Krishna Prema, that is complete. Isn't it? Krishna Prema is complete. Follow. I can expand this point. In Upanishad, that is why sometime he heard advice from Guru Varga, Gurudev, Guru Varga, that my son, if you feel saturation point inside your heart, okay, I will have to do more and more bhajan, that is different. But regarding material thing, Labha-puja-pratishtha, useless. If Pratishtha is not going to touch me, then enough Pratishtha can come in my life. Who care, man? If Pratishtha is not going to touch my heart, contaminate my heart, why not Pratishtha can come? Because that is Vaishnavi Pratishtha. If Pratishtha is going to contaminate my heart, then it is not Vaishnavi Pratishtha. He is going to contaminate me. I am not at all ready to give all Pratishtha to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. That's why I am speaking this way. Otherwise, I was supposed to, at the time of initiation, it is my commitment that Diksha Kale Shishya Karya Atma Samarpan from Rupa Goswami Pad, from Jiva Goswami Pad, from Prabhupada I can discuss, Bhakti Vinod Thakur I can discuss. All this point for this coming days. So, Diksha Kale submission, I was supposed to submit 100%, but I show false submission. My submission is false. So I cannot expect. So how can I expect that I can cross this material world? Bonded condition is there in my inside. Maybe 60% bondage gone, but 40% bondage is still there. Maybe okay, 90% gone, but 10% bondage is still there. Still you are bonded. But 99% bondage gone, still danger. 100% gone. How I can realize? I can realize through the example of Kuresh, who is going to give everything to for Gurudev, spiritual master, to Ramanujaju. I can give everything, what to speak about body. What to speak about body. Everything what I have. Name, fame, position, power, education, money, whatever you think, all I. That is Rupa Goswami speaking. Labdharpanam. Try to understand this point. It's Labdharpanam. You learn this thing? The day you learn, the day you understand this Labdharpanam, you can find saturation. You need not go through Sanskrit words. You can go to Kirtan. Bhaktivinoda speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Kirtan speaking. What speaking? But I am now very happy. Atmo nivedan tuva pade kori hoinu paramo sukhi dukho dure gelo chinta na rohilo chodike anando heri. You have to sing day and night. Foolish, I am giving blood to you. I am not expecting in return, nothing. Atma nivedan tuva pade kori hoini param sukhi. Why I am enjoying transcendental bliss? The only reason, I give everything unto you. I give everything to you, I reserve nothing for me. I reserve nothing for me so that you can make me angry. How possible a Vaishnava become angry? How is possible that Vaishnava can become angry, can do some dirty thing, can pass some dirty remark? Not possible. Vaishnava is Supreme Lord and Vaishnava all same. I mean, Parikar, Shakshat Harityana Samastra Sastri, Rukto Sata Babbate Vasadvi, Kintu Pur Yupiya Vatasya. So, Atma Nivedan Tuva Panepadi, Tuva Pade Kori, Rupa Goswami, Labdhar Panam. You have to learn this thing. I never try to reserve something for my personal. I don't like to. Personal, if I am going to reserve something, that is a great danger for me. Responsibility coming on me. Prabhupada speaking, we all are postmen. I am going to get this message and hand over to you. This is the message sent by Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada. You cannot fight with me. Each and every moment I can show you documents that I speak from this and there. So I am acting like postman, nothing to do. If you like to fight, you have to fight with Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Kesava Goswami, you can go and fight. Why you are fighting? I am just projecting their, Siddhanta Vishar, everything. So it is written there, Labdharpanam, the final saturation point, if not coming in my life, then I can become very angry if somebody is speaking something against me. Naturally. Naturally. If you speak, that day I was speaking in, you know, Chandrakana in Bengali, and also many times in later to some acharya, big acharya wanted to cheat me, I write openly. I'm not speaking all rubbish, I speak. If somebody is going to speak, ShyamBaba is very genius personality. I am not happy. If somebody is going to speak, ShyamBaba is a beast. Still, I am not going to pain, feeling any pain. Tulla ninda stuti mauni santushta jena kena chita ani keto stira matir bhakti man me priya naraha. All same. Because who is going to pass this kind of remark? That you are genius, he is also a material person, here what he is speaking is also material word, and we are speaking you are a beast, okay, it is also material word. It is also material word. And the person he is speaking, he is also material. And the word he is speaking all material. Material world going to be destroyed. Material world, bhutakase bilin. So let them speak. What is concerned to me? Why you bother about that? If you are at all interested about Krishna Bhajan? Prabhupada speaking, only solution in your life, only solution. If you are 100% ready to do Krishna Bhajan, in infinity life, otherwise you cannot get any solutions, cannot get solution. No solution there. Birth after birth, billions of birth, no solution. One acharya there, that side of river, they're speaking all rubbish again. Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, genuine Paramahansa. Genuine Paramahansa. I can touch Salgram, I can touch Susi. Genuine, I never see this kind of, oh, oh. This kind of trinadapi, oh my God. He, somebody is speaking all rubbish against him. He is not giving any honor. Puri Maharaj, Puri Maharaj, Puri Maharaj is busy with Archan. He is Kanishtha Adhikari, speaking this way. Message coming to temple, our temple, and somebody going to speak to Guru Maharaj in a very humble way. Maharaj, after that Acharya gone, who used to love you as a godbrother, very much used to cry for him. Now he present Acharya speaking this way, that you are actually Kanishtha Adhikari because you are busy with Guru Maharaj laughing. So why you are going to get pain for that? I'm very lucky that at least he is going to count me in the range of Kanishtha Bhakta. I think I have no Kanishtha Bhakta. At least you should be very happy. Oh my God. You are crying? That time Guru Maharaj was externally very poor. But financially, if Guru Maharaj is poor, if you can discover, if you are 100% foolish and idiot, you can misunderstand him. Vaishnava jato dekho byabaharik dukho. In exchange, in physical life, if you find that Vaishnava is having some disease, he has no money, if you find that you are going to fall down. I can discuss from Rupa Goswami. Drishtva sabhava janitai. This sloka I can discuss someday. Guru Maharaj, Prabhupad, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, who not? Keshav Goswami Maharaj, everybody going, traveling to local train. I am also, all the time, pushing, dancing, local train I am going because minimum fare. I will have to keep money for, you know, publication, this, that, Goshala, how I can spend money. So this way I am traveling still today by saying, I am doing, you can follow me. This way, that doesn't mean I am doing something good. It's our duty to do it. At present, who is not knowing ABCD about Bhajan? He is also. Like Ravan. Ravan wanted to capture all the, you know, authority, power. That was the reason for why Ravan was bound to die. Ravan was impersonalist, mayavadi. But what I mean to say, one day Guru Maharaj going by local train, and somebody coming in front of Guru Maharaj and touching on head and choking. And beside some disciple was there, "Hey, what you are doing?" He become very angry. "Why you touch? You know who is it? Follow what I say." The Guru Maharaj laughing. "Why don't you understand that he is going to bless me? Why do you understand that he is going to bless me? Why you become angry?" This is the mood of Vaishnava. I learned from Guru Padma. But if you speak, you will have to stop speaking this way. I cannot stop. Because this is the order I get from up. I cannot stop speaking about the absolute truth. I can live or die, it matters little. So I have to speak this way. So this way, actually, I learned from Guru Padma. What kind of humble attitude? What kind of humbleness? What kind of humble attitude there with Prabhupad, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Gaur Kishore Baba? That is why Gaur Kishore Baba is speaking, na? After my death, it is my request, you all tie my leg with rope and pull me like a dead dog on street of Navadvip. You can pull and throw me in Ganga. Those who are actual Vaishnava, they can realize. They can realize the heart of Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, Vipralamba Bhav. What is the humble attitude? What is the humble attitude? Oh, when we can reach that point, oh my God. So they took decision to throw Gaur Kishore Baba that way. Prabhupada like lion speaking. "You idiot! How you think that way? My Guru Padma Paramahansa Sestha, whom Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to give salute? You are my devotee." Like Prahlad Maharaj, Nishingadev speaking. "Prahlad, I am going to give you honor, special honor." "What honor? I don't need anything. You have to take." Nishingadev giving, you know, openly this statement. "If anybody going to ask me, Prabhu, we like to see the sample of your devotee." Said, "You see, Prahlad, you are Madhbhakta Pratirupadrik. Prahlad, you are Madhbhakta Pratirupadrik. If somebody is asking how your devotee is, what looking, how? See, Prahlad, then you can understand. This kind of honor given by Supreme Lord Nishingadev. Now you understand what kind of humble attitude, what kind of submission we will have to learn from Prahlad Maharaj. Don't say we'll have to say Rupanuga Bhajan. Foolish. If sub Paramanna I forget to give Paramanna, you are going to kick me. Why am I in my plate there is no Paramanna? Huh? You are going to do Rupanuga Bhajan. Foolish number one. Make fool of me. Huh? Simple Paramanna is not there. Finish. Beating. Why not Paramanna is there? This is our Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. So you see, so this way we are going to mislead. We are all misled. We are going to misguide others. So you see, Prabhupada speaking so many things, but time cannot permit, but still I will have to speak. So you can see that last remark I passed from Mahabharata. Nasanti anayaka nasanti kunayaka nasanti bahunayaka taranti sunayaka. Those who are going to get the guidance, luckily going to get the guidance of a proper personality, spiritually elevated soul, then you are lucky. You are lucky. So, Ambarish Maharaj, Pritham Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj, they are going to give guidance properly to everybody. And Bhakti Vinod Thakur crying 150 years back. That time, Bhakti Vinod, I can show you. Bhakti Vinod Thakur crying. If at present those who are acting as a guide and going to guide the whole world, whole society, if they are not going to play their head over this issue, that how they can get bhakti, then total system going to be break down. Samosto Gaurangir Bimal Siksha Dhangsho Hai Jave. But still, Phalgunadi, there can be a trace one, you know, Bhakti Vinod Dhara can never be destroyed. So, okay. But still, externally, great danger waiting for us. Like Jodu Deshwini, they are fighting with each other and killing. Simply for simple Patishtha. Simply for Patishtha. So, those who are going to speak that ShyamBaba is genius, I am not going to get any enjoyment for that. And those who are going to speak, actually he is a beast, all same for me, because of material sound. If at all Prabhupada Bhakti Vinod Thakur or Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada, you know, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami, Santo Goswami Maharaj are going to speak, then really ShyamBaba is very. Guru Padmanabha used to joke with me many times. Bap ka beta, sipai ka gora, kuch nahi to thora thora. Hindi. Guru Maharaj used to laugh and speak. What is the meaning? Why are you speaking this way? Bap ka beta, sipai ka gora, kuch nahi to thora thora. Sipai mean, who is a policeman having some trap, you know, mountain police, having trained horse. He is having some idea about what his master speaking. Follow. And Bap ka beta, and the son, the right son of right father, is having some indication. What to do, what time, how. It's no. Guru Padmanabha used to do this joking with me. Bap ka beta, sipai ka gora, kuch nahi to thoda thoda. Now I feel why he was bound to speak that way. That's mean he wanted to bless me, to do something concrete, not to waste my time. Not to follow other people, those who are going to hell. Not that way. You can remember from Mahabharata, I can show you. Pitamahavishya speaking. What Ravis is speaking, you know I am totally brahmacharya. From my childhood, from my birth, my Gurudev speaking, you will have to marry. Huh? I have taken resolution not to marry. Why are you speaking this way? You will have to marry. Huh? This kind of guru should be thrown out. I don't like that kind of guru who is going to misguide me. Because not the question of this body, question of birth after birth, infinity period. Pitamavishya teaching us. One, he don't know what to do, what not to do, when, what to do. Don't know it. He's speaking this way. Huh? We have to leave that kind of guru who is going to misguide us. You can remember another sloka I was quoting from Bhagavatam. Now I can come back to the point. What is that? Shuta sabungsam suchiro sramasya nanjosa virita artha tat tat gunanu sabanam mikunda padaravinda hijesu jesham. If some of my Guru Marga are going to speak, okay. My son, ShyamBaba trying something, okay. Something concrete. He is not going to misguide people. Better, okay. Okay, still. Shakto griha bhanjane, I remember. Asakto ham griharambe shakto ham griha bhanjane. I can make the whole building is, you know, into a dust particle, I can break and make into dust powder. That I can do. I can make in. I cannot make in. Ashaktoham griharambhe. Shaktoham grihabhanjane. I can break, demolish the whole system of bhajan. That I can do very easily. Yes, I am habituated to do it. I can do it. This is my capacity, that I can speak. Can you arrange one drop of Shraddha inside my heart? Can you arrange? Then I can speak, you are Acharya. Can you arrange? One drop of Shraddha, I pray, I am cravingly speaking. Please give me one drop of Shraddha in my life, so that I can save my life. Can you give me? You cannot give. But you can destroy the whole system. Ramanujacharya was given poison with prasadam. Ramanujacharya was given poison with charanamrita. Ramanujacharya was insulted. But still, Ramanujacharya never wanted to take any revenge against anybody. One day, some important papers, some Maharaj giving to some brahmachari. He already carrying this paper, and in the temple, Maharaj speaking, give those papers to me. Maharaj, actually, monkey coming and take. Maharaj was very angry, wanted to beat him, idiot. Paper all lost. He wanted to break his head. So angry, so angry. I was there with folded hand. And another Maharaj was there. He is speaking, Maharaj, why not you see the desire of Krishna? Why not you look the desire of Krishna? Maybe is it the desire of Krishna? That's why you're losing this paper. Same thing happened with Prabhupada. Prabhupada writing a fantastic commentary of Janmadasa Sloka. You cannot imagine. So nice commentary. That time Prabhupada go away from this place and take shelter in a very, you know, in a solitary place. That time one brahmachari was there only. Near, from Krishnanagar you will have to go, that place. From Krishnanagar you have to go that place. British people, before going, they leave this area and property with Gauriamat. Follow? There Prabhupada used to do some writing, solitary, whole day and night. After writing is complete, Prabhupada was very satisfied. Gauranga helped me, Nityananda helped me to write that way. Okay. Keep this paper there. In the morning time, paper is vanished. Oh my God! For 1 month energy I give, where the paper gone? Oh, nobody can trace out. Where gone? Prabhupada was a little bit anxious, but after that, thinking, what is the desire of Nityananda Gaur, I don't know. Let me write again. Prabhupada started writing again. Complete that. But speaking, the previous one was more, you know. But after some time, the sevak discovered the paper taken by mouse inside hole. Mouse inside hole, all paper gone. Big mouse, you know. Not mouse, a rat, not mouse. Rat. Prabhupada giving this example. A rat or mouse cannot make anything. Grain, cannot produce grain, or cannot make print books, nothing. But they can cut all books and papers, everything very easily, and destroy all the godown of, you know, store godown of, that they can do. So my behavior is like that. My nature is like that rat. My nature is like rat and mouse. That I can do. I can destroy all Gauriya system, everything, all documents, all papers, so that I can vanish like Hitler. I can make a new world. Vishwamitra also wanted to make a new world. Vishwamitra world was, I am powerful. I am actually, you know, so powerful. I have my power. Astronomers also wanted to make new world. This is the condition. So this way I cannot do something concrete, but I can destroy. There is the, you know, so you see, from Srimad Bhagavatam, I was bound to speak this sloka to give you remember, if you love Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, if you love Prabhupada, you will have to spread this news, whole world. Not even a single penny I demand from you. I promise openly from you. I want nothing, no position. Leave me alone so that I can die very peacefully, very nice. In the midst of Guru Vaishnava Sankirtan, I can leave my body. Bhaman Goswami used to speak, I like to die unknown, unseen. Bhaman Goswami, what is the meaning? For Vaishnavi Patishtha, if all Patishtha I am going to pass away to Prabhupada, let enough Patishtha can come in my life. It is not stool and urine. I cannot touch that dirty thing. Guru Maharaj, learn, teach me how to maintain purity. That purity I should learn first. How this kind of dirty thing, Labha-puja-pratishtha, Kamini Kanchan cannot touch my heart to contaminate. Harikatha I am speaking? Harikatha Popa speaking? Harikatha Guru Padpada Keshav Goswami speaking? They are sitting inside my heart? They are speaking, I am not speaking. The day I think I am writing so nicely, I am speaking so Harikatha, then all stool and urine can come from my mouth. The day I can conceive, the day I can think that I can speak nice Harikatha, you know, I am speaking nice Harikatha, nice writing, that day all stool and urine coming from my mouth. Don't try to attain my Harikatha. But today, if I get one person, genuine person, like Shukadev Goswami was thinking, I need one genuine devotee who can hear. I need one person who can hear. Then the fire can glow someday. I need one person who can realize and feel. Only one person in front of whom I can go on speaking. And after that, after my death, he can take this candle, torchlight and show the light of everyone. That I want. I don't expect the thousands of people like cows. I cannot expect. Impossible. Quality and quantity cannot persist together. Who can digest this kind? Who can digest this kind of Harikatha? Who can you say? One person you show. One person you show me. Who can digest this? They can all think me enemy. Because they, in Chandrakhana, they like to stop my Harikatha, big agitation, they like to stop everywhere. Don't go to the Harikatha Shyam Baba. Everywhere. For the past 1 month, they are trying. When I reach there, I pay dandava to the temple there. Let them insult me. What it happens to me? I pay dandava, they insult me, okay, very nice. I come and sit for Harikatha. Thus. Then I open it, declare, what is the defect with me? You will have to show me. Because judge, when going to pass one kind of death sentence, that he can be hanged to death, then before that he is going to deliver the speech that for this reason you are giving this kind of punishment. I like to hear this kind of that kind of thing. For why, what reason they are going to stop people to come to my Harikatha? What can be the reason? One thing. You show me one loophole. Then, if you are not coming, then I can think this way. Maybe I am loose character. Can you prove? Maybe my character is not good. Or maybe if I am going to speak Harikatha, then you can become naked. This can be the reason. What reason? Maybe I am characterless. Or maybe the second reason can be the option. That is, when I am speaking Harikatha, you can feel full naked. That can be the reason. Then you will have to judge what can be the reason. I like to lead my life very simple way, like beggar. But with Jukta Vairagya. As and when necessary, I love to speak like fire. Other time like beggar. With coping, that I learned from Prabhupada. I'm not going to act. I'm not an actor. So you see, Sutasya Pungsam Suchira Samasya Nanjo Sasuri Virita Artha Tattat Gunanu Sabanam Mukunda Padaravinda Hidesh. This is the advice of Bhagavatam. Come on! You are going to kick this advice. This is the advice of Bhagavatam. You are going to kick this advice. It is written, those elevated, exalted devotees, those who are going to confine Supreme Lord, His lotus feet and their heart and lock. Supreme Lord is sold to them. Mahaprabhu many times told, I am sold to you. By your service, Seva. Sevak Tattva is more than Sevva Tattva. Sevak Tattva is more than Sevva Tattva. Who is Krishna? We want to know Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Who is Krishna? We want to understand the glories of Radharani. That is called Raganuga Paddhati. Anyhow, we want to understand the glories of Radharani. I am not speaking, Prabhupada speaking, Siddharma is all speaking, same way. You can go through papers, you can find all, I am in line. You can find. You can check up, I am speaking on lie or not. Siddhartha Goswami also speaking, Prabhupada speaking. Yatha yatha gaura padar vinde vinde tabhaktim kitupunna rasi tatha tatha utsarpati hidyakasmat radha padam mujo sudham murasi. How you can understand the glories of Radharani? He is not a woman. You can go and check up how nice, beautiful lady is there. Eh? What is the condition of bondage soul? I can discuss tomorrow. What Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Tomorrow I can discuss the condition, painful condition of bondage soul. So you see the condition. Whereas Srimad Bhagavatam speaking, you are going to put all your energy to search Vedanta, Pura and Upanishad. Why you are going to take trouble? Eh? Why not you serve this Guru Vaishnava? You can get all power. In Upanishad, we get one nice advice. What is the advice? You are still today feeling some dissatisfaction. You have no money, no position. Eh? You are going to find no saturation is there in your life. Why? Discontent, dissatisfaction. Why? You are devotee. If you are devotee, if I am devotee, what symptom can be there? I can show you day by day. Then you will have to take decision. I am going to speak Siddhanta only. I have no enmity with anybody. Nobody can prove. I love everybody. I love everybody. I have no enmity. So in Upanishad, we get one very nice advice. Guru Varga used to speak this point. What is that? That yasmin prapte sarvam idam praptum bhavati, yasmin gyate sarvam idam gyatum bhavati, vigyatum bhavati. Jasmin gyate sarvam idam vigyatum bhavati, yasmin prapte sarvam idam praptum bhavati. You will have to concentrate on this point. After getting that property, you are not going to expect any property. Prem dhan bina vyatho jaridya jivan das kori vetan more deho prem dhan. That is the property I want. So in Upanishad speaking, I will have to clarify this point day by day. So in Upanishad we find very nice advice. After knowing the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, what can be left in the world to know? Physics, chemistry, mathematics, astronomy, astrology, biology, nothing left. If I know the lotus feet of Krishna, all complete. You will have to feel that point. That is called Pakka Shraddha. That is called perfect shraddha. Shraddha sabde koi shudhira vishwas. Krishna bhakti koi le sarvakim. So it is the advice of Upanishad that you have to think over and again this point. What is that point? That jasmin gyate sarvamidam vikadam bhavati. But now you are resting unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Krishna is all omnipresent. Krishna is full of six affluences. So what deficit can be there in my life? If I can discover I am the servant of Krishna, jive sarupa Krishna nitya das, finally I can draw conclusion about jiva's nitya sarup, what jiva Goswami speak, what Vishwanath Chakur, what Prabhupada, all Bhakti Vinod Thakur I can prove, ultimately, last day. So you see, after getting that property, I cannot feel any dissatisfaction. After knowing the lotus feet of Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, nothing can be left in my life to know. Sarvam idam vigyatam bhavati. You should remember this point. That's why when Katayani and Gargi, when husband Jagyavalka going away, Jagyavalka going away to take sannyas and going to distribute all big property was there, left with Yagyavalka. He used to do jag, jagya, everything, everybody gave donation. So all kept there. Going to distribute this property into two parts, two wives. Then before going away for sannyas, two wives asking, "Who husband? We have one question." "What question?" "But the property you are giving us, we can get full satisfaction, everything. The property you are going to distribute among us two, you think we can get everything by that? What do you think, husband?" Husband said, "No. Sorry, excuse me, you cannot get satisfaction. What to do? I am going to distribute among you, I am not going to speak lie. This property cannot give you satisfaction. This property cannot give you full satisfaction, nothing. Jasmin gatye sarvamidam vigyatam bhavati, jasmin prapti sarvamidam praptum bhavati. Why not you are going to advise us that point? What treasure we need? Jenaham na asnute, jenaham na asnute, paramam padam, what by word I forget. Tenaham kim kuryam. That property you are giving to give us, with the help of which I cannot get absolute benefit, you are going to this. What we can do? Jenaham na amritam asnute. We can get amrita? This property you are going to distribute among us? Ho husband? Then why you are distributing? Gargi and Maitreyi, very appealing mood speaking. Jenaham na amritam asnute, tenaham kim kurjam. This property cannot give me this nectar, but you are giving distributing this food. What we can do with this? This kind of realization you have in your life, in our life we have. If we have, then green signal you can get. What we can do? All material parties, everybody can worship me, everyone can wash my lotus feet, give big garland. Women can also come and give garland, where it's prohibited, strictly prohibited. We cannot allow Matajis, we respect Mataji. You all my Mataji, but I cannot allow you to touch and give garland, nothing. How it is possible that a woman giving garland, so strictly prohibited. It is not at all allowed. It's not the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not at all. Not at all allowed. So you see there it is written that Gargi Katha and they speaking. Jenaham na amritam asnuti tenaham kim kuryam. But cannot give treasure, amrita. What you can do with this property? Tenaham kim kuryam. What use, what utility you are giving me? Giving us. Now it is in Bhagavatam Siddhanta, third canto, Srutasvapamsam Suchira. Why you are going to take trouble to go through Upanishad, Ved, Vedanta? You want to prove that you are a big scholar? You are a erudite scholar. You have a big proficiency. In Vrindavan, those idiots like to prove that Bhakti Vinod Thakur speaking lie. Follow, they like to, we chappal, we like to beat them. But whole society is silent. We don't find that they have backbone. Follow what I say. They don't have any backbone. If at all they have backbone, they can go and speak, why you are speaking this way? They don't have even backbone to see how they can act as leader. No backbone is there. They are like sarisi, like snack, and they don't have backbone to stand. That's why they are. Why not you make one nice group? Even Muslim people, they are fighting with each other. Example I'm bound to give. If you go and speak something to one Muslim people, all they can get together and fight with you. Why you speak? But we have no unity. One Japanese team came from Japan. They wanted to visit the spiritual places of India. They were in Barsana. They are very happy to see everything, very happy. After that, they are bound to pass this kind of remark. So nice spiritual treasure there in India. Oh my God. We are unlucky. But lack of unity, lack of integrity, lack of humanity. What honor we can get as a devotee. I think I am not devotee. I think I am not devotee. Don't come to me. Don't worship me. Even if you give one garland, it is one danger for me. Dok, sit, hear Harikatha. If anybody is going to give, hey, sit, don't waste your time. One fraction of second, allow me to speak something which is concrete. I don't need garland. You put it here. Give in Bhagavatam and give to Tulsi. I don't need garland. So sorry. I like to die before hearing all rubbish again, Guru Vaishnava. Why Krishna Bhagavan not arranging that I should die before hearing? So you see those Japanese team passing remark this way. The lack of, you know, unity. Lack of unity, lack of integrity, lack of nationality there. How they can go ahead? How they can go ahead in material point of view or spiritual point of view? Neither way. Material point of view, still you will have to understand something, because you understand liberty means to do something what is not allowed. Well, India is liberty, enjoying liberty. I can do anything in life. You think this way. So idiot Indian people. Previously, they are not idiot at present. They think whatever we like, we can do because India is free. India is free. We are enjoying freedom. So freedom means whatever we like, we can do. Really, this is the meaning of freedom. So really, this is the meaning of freedom. You know. Even one British people passing remark, nice, I heard when I was student only. When I was only student, there I heard. Very nice, I was very happy to hear this thing. What do you mean by liberty? You go to street, any sadhu, you go to any sadhu and speak, what do you mean by liberty? Let them speak, Gauriya Siddhanta, they cannot speak. They never hear Gauriya Siddhanta. How they can speak? They are not approaching one Gauriya devotee. Liberty means curtailment of your own right for the sake of others, so that mutual interest can be protected and final goal can be attained. Final goal means prosperity of country. Goal can be attained. There's so many meanings. So many meanings. What is the meaning of marriage? Sometimes I speak, it is my rage. You are running after marriage. But the meaning is that, as per, very nice. I can speak, if you learn Bengali, I can show you. Jadidam hidayam mamo, tadidam hidayam tabo. What does it mean? My heart and your heart unifies. I cannot have any separate desire. In the case of material marriage, if this kind of thing can happen, why not in the case of initiation? My question to you all, why this is from Veda, this mantra, Samveda? Why not it is applicable in the case of, you know, in the case of, you know, Bhajan, at the time of Diksha, why not applicable? Whereas it is applicable in a marriage field, your heart and my heart unified. There is no separate identity, only body is different. And that outside philosopher, I am very happy, is speaking. Marriage is nothing but friendship between two human souls having two different body, separate body. Very nice meaning. But as per Indian philosophy, why that time husband going to die? Husband is already died, then wife going to die. Sahamaran. They are going to leave body because husband gone. What is the meaning? They want to make dirty meaning. Vidyasagar Mahasaya also could not trace out the actual meaning because he was not devotee. But he was a right man. I respect him. At least that kind of truthfulness should be there in my life. Vidyasagar is more than me. Because never he wanted to take shelter of lie. But every faction of second, I am going to take shelter of lie. That much different. Of course, Bhakti Vinod Thakur wanted to prove Vidyasagar Pandit Mahasaya. That day you speaking that you never like to pass any remark. What you don't know, you don't like to pass any. What you have not seen. Now, how you are passing remark about Krishna, impersonal, then Vidyasagar will stop. Vidyasagar Mahasaya could learn from that small boy, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, small boy. Okay, he is giving him a lesson. I myself wrote in Shudhodai Grantho that what I cannot see, I cannot believe. So you have already seen Supreme Lord? So you are passing remark that Supreme Lord is impersonal? No. Then why you are passing remark? So Bhakti Vinod Thakur is teacher or Vidyasagar teacher? Externally, Vidyasagar is teacher. A student. But actually, to be frank, Vidyasagar is student. Vidyasagar is student. Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay is the Scot of England, they speak, compare. We say Bankim, Scot is the Bankim of Britain. We can speak this way. Opposite. Because so much quality is there, you don't have that kind of quality. British people, they are popped up, they can speak this way. To be frank, we have to speak. So much quality is there. At the same time, he was barrister, a district magistrate, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and he also. At the same time, so powerful, so nice sanskar. But bhakti sanskar was not there. He can explain Gita, but we are less interested to hear Gita from you. He can explain Gita, pages after, so big pandit. He is writing so many things. Bande Mataram. He is writing this. So nice. He is writing so nicely. But still, we are less interested. We cannot compare them with Bhakti Vinod Thakur. If Bhakti Vinod Thakur at all was interested to expose him as a poet and writer, nobody was there that time who can stand in front of Bhakti Vinod Thakur. But Bhakti Vinod Thakur never wanted to lead life that way. Totally dedicated life, devotional life. So you see, what I wanted to speak, that is, sutasapungsam suchira samasya nanya sasuri virita artha tattvat gunanu sabalam mukunda padara vinda hidaye sujesham. Why not you go and serve those pure devotees? They confine the lotus feet of Supreme Lord into their heart. You don't know. You think they are all ordinary men because they don't have money. Oh my God. That's why Prabhupada told, don't try to run from money, temple, anything, big. Bhakti Vinod Thakur told. If you go, immense treasure can make you blind like owl. And you can go on passing remarks like ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba, all rubbish. You can have the privilege to take you to hell. Because you have money. Money power can make you blind. Your position can make you blind. You can never get back your eyes. Kuresh someday could get back his eyes. But you cannot get back. The case of Kuresh was totally separate. Kuresh can get back. Yes, Kuresh could get back eyes. So eyes, so nice eyes, with which he can see past, present and future. He can see Tad Vishnum Paramam Padam Sada Pasvanti Surayo Divibo Chakshuratatam. Those Guru Vaishnav, with open eyes, they are not going to meditate. The open eyes, they can all the time going to through roads and market everywhere speaking Harikatha. They can see the eternal existence of the lotus feet of Nityananda and Gaur. That's why they can speak Harikatha. If you are blind, then you cannot speak Harikatha. Some stool and urine can come. Maybe thousands of people, lakhs of people going together. What it concerns to us? Sarup Gosai is not going to give certificate. If you can get certificate from Sarup Gosai, then I can admit that you are a Gauri Acharya. Can you get one certificate from Sarup Gosai? Sarup Gosai is the master, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu making him. I can explain this point after. So you see, today I can stop here because time limited. You are going to take trouble to memorize Suti Siti to prove that I am a great scholar, I can write so many things, I can. But you are going to get deviated from the track of Prabhupada. I can show you, Bhakti Siddhanta. Slightest deviation from the track of Srila Prabhupada can throw you ultimately in the ocean of misery. What kind of comment people can pass? Let them pass. What kind of comment Sarup Gosai is going to pass? That is very important. Who is going to speak me that you are idiot, rascal, you are actually an a beast? Okay, very nice. But who are you to give me certificate? Give me written certificate, I can put in paper. That I am a beast, I am an idiot, rascal, I can put in print, in paper. Who giving? You will have to show this name. Promise, sir, is heading should be there. Which organization, which company or which spiritual going to give me, sir? I want this kind of certificate, you give me. So that people not going to disturb me. I want, you show me. So you see, this way, all you see it is written there, that oh, you are unnecessarily going to take trouble. You can get everything, all direct realization. I can give direct example how Bihari, the illiterate personality, could get all total realization from Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. I can give evidence and proof. Then you can believe me. Otherwise, you cannot believe. I know you are going to follow them. I know you are not going to follow them. I have no position, rank, nothing. Why you can follow me? It's good. So, this way, I can try to prove what is the Gauriya preaching procedure, how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda wanted to preach, all secret thing, and what should be quality, day by your blessing, I am looking unto a lotus feet, you can bless me, I can try to discuss all those things. So, you see, Sutasapungsam Suchira Samasananja Sabir Truita Atto Tattad Gunanu Sabanam Mukunda Padara Vinda Hideshi Jesham. This way, if we can run our humble life, trinadapi life, sure, 100% sure. 100%. Kishnat Kirtana Gana Nortano Kalapatho Jani Vrajita Sadvaktavali Hangsa Chakramadupo Seni Viharaspadam Karnanandi Kaladhanir Vahatume Juhamaru Prangani Si Chaitanya Jani Dheta Valasad Lila Sudha Swardhuni Vanchakalpataru Sikapa Sindhubhavacha Patitanam Bhavana Vaishnava Bhyur. Excuse me, don't misunderstand me. Repeatedly I am saying, don't misunderstand me.